Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchaka Upatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing about the travels of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, who was able, by the power of his mantra, to go to the Vaikuntha planets. So while he was in Vaikuntha, he was able to go to a place in Vaikuntha called Dwarka, and there he met Uddhava, and then later on Narada Muni also came there. And Narada Muni is describing to Gop Kumar about the special nature of a place far beyond Dwarka, far beyond Vaikuntha, which is called Goloka.
Narada Muni 就像Gopakumar描述说，有一个地方，它是远远超越于Vaikuntha之上的。它这个地方名字叫Goloka，描述了这个地方的本性。
So Narada Muni is telling special qualities of Lord Krishna, and he's describing the different pastimes which Lord Krishna performed when he appeared in the material world. So he was describing about Krishna's childhood, and he was describing how Lord Brahma had a pastime with Lord Krishna. So Brahma, of course, Brahma tried to steal away he stole away the cowherd boys, and they took away all the calves from Lord Krishna and left Lord Krishna on his own. So Lord Krishna used his inconceivable potencies, and he expanded himself, and he took the place of all the cows and all the cowherd boys, and it lasted for 1 year. So Lord Brahma was defeated by Lord Krishna. Lord Brahma was thinking he would show his power to before Krishna. But Brahma was humiliated. He was completely defeated. His power was so insignificant before the power of Lord Krishna. But by this pastime, Lord Brahma was able to better understand Krishna's pastimes in Gokula. Gokula is Vrindavan in the material world.
但是即使这一次的消失光，主 Brahma 就彻底的理解了，主 Krishna 在 Gokula 的消失光。Gokula 呢是在物质世界的 Vrindavan。
And Brahma was so much impressed by the people of Vrindavan that he prayed that in the next life he could take birth as even a plant or blade of grass in Vrindavan.
主 Brahma 就这样留下了深刻的印象，他祈求下一世能够成为 Vrindavan 的居民，或者是成为一株植物，甚至一株草，一丛草也可以。
Yeah, he thought he could. He thought this way I'd be able to get the dust from the feet of all these people of Vrindavan, because these people of Vrindavan are so great devotees.
他想，如此这样一般呢，我就可以得到文大文居民足下的尘土。这些居民全部都是伟大奉献者。
He knew they would never agree to give the dust from their feet, but if he could take birth as grass or as a plant, then he could get the dust.
他深知这些居民永远不会答应把他们足下的尘土给予主 Brahma， 但是如果他变成一株草或者一丛植物，他就可以得到这些尘土。
And he prayed if he couldn't take birth in Vrindavan, that he could take birth just outside Vrindavan, so that when the people would come out of Vrindavan, at that time he may be able to get the dust from their feet.
他还祈求，倘若他不能出生在 Vrindavan 的境内，甚至投生在 Vrindavan 境外也可以，因为这样 Vrindavan 居民从 Vrindavan 出来的时候，他就能得到他们足下的尘土。
So this pastime was very helpful for Lord Brahma to better understand the transcendental nature of Lord Krishna and how he deals with his devotees.
这个消失光使得主 Brahma 就对 Krishna 超然的本性以及他和那里的奉献者之间的交流有了深入的理解。
And Brahma saw how all the cows and all the ladies of Vrindavan, how they loved Krishna so much that while Krishna was taking the place of their sons, Krishna would drink their milk. He'd drink the milk of the cows and he'd drink the breast milk of the mothers, the gopis.
Chu Brahma 也对于 Vrindavan 的那些母牛以及 Vrindavan 的那些女士对 Krishna 这件爱也有了深入的了解。因为主 Krishna 可以吸吮他们的乳汁，也吸吮这些母牛的乳汁。
Okay, so then Narada Muni is describing more pastimes about Krishna. He mentions about how Krishna, how he's always tending the cows, and how he gives great respect to his elder brother Balaram.
那的牧尼又描述了更多 Krishna 的消失光，他是如何照料那些母牛，并且尊重他的兄长 Balarama。
And while Krishna's always glorifying and praising the beauty of Vrindavan, the beauty of the forests of Vrindavan.
Krishna 一直在荣耀着 Vrindavan 森林的美丽。
And he likes to imitate, he would imitate the sounds of the different animals in Vrindavan. Sometimes he would make the sound of the parrots, and sometimes he'd make the sound of the cows, and sometimes he'd make the sound of the bees.
有时候他模仿着这些动物的声音，有时候他是模仿那些鹦鹉，鹦鹉的鸣叫，有的时候模仿那些母牛的声音，还有那些蜜蜂的声音。
And in the forest, they would lay down on leaves to take rest. They'd just use whatever was provided by nature. They're very happy to enjoy the gifts of nature.
有时候他们会躺在这个树叶上面休息， Vrindavan 的这个自然提供了他们享受的一切。
Then Narada Muni talks about how Krishna killed the Danuka demon in the Talavan forest.
Narada Muni 又描述了 Krishna 是如何杀死了在 Talavan 森林杀死了 Danuka 驴魔。
Right, the Danuka demon with all his ass friends, they took the whole Talavan forest and there were many nice fruits in the Talavan forest. And nobody could go there because this Danuka demon was there. He wouldn't let anybody come there.
Danuka Sura 就和他那些恶魔朋友就占据了 Talavan 森林，但是这个 Talavan 森林就长满着味美多汁的果实，但是他们不允许任何人进去。
The cowherd boys knew there was nice fruits, beautiful, tasty fruits, and they liked to also play with these fruits. They would throw them like a ball. But they couldn't get in the forest there because these demons were there in the form of asses, and they would attack anybody who came there.
果实呢都是味美多汁的，非常诱人，而且牧牛童朋友一些人。
So the cowherd boys, they said to Krishna and Balaram, you know that you two boys are very strong. You know, we think you could kill these demons. Why don't you go there and get rid of these demons so that we can also enjoy the forest of Talavan?
所以这些男孩呢就怂恿 Krishna 和 Balaram 说。我们知道你们俩是特别有力量的身强力壮的小伙子，为什么你们不进入这个森林，然后就处理掉这些恶魔呢？
Nature of these demons, you see, demons are thinking this is mine. Don't come here. This is only for me. Actually, it's all Krishna's property.
这就是恶魔的本。他们总是把一切都据为己有，认为这是我的，但实际上一切都是 Krishna 的财产。
So Krishna and Balaram went into Talavan forest, and Balaram came in and he took one. He got there was a tree with many fruits, and Balaram shook the tree, and a number of fruits they fell from the tree, and when the fruits fell on the ground, it made a sound. And so it alerted the demon, and the big demon Danuka came running. Who's in my forest? Who's touching my fruits?
然后 Krishna 和 Balarama 就进入到 Talavan 森林。Krishna 就开始晃动一棵大树，然后使得树上的一些成熟的果实从上面掉了下来，这样就惊动了那个 Danuka Sura. 他一下就冲了过来，到底是谁碰了我的？
And so the demon Danuka came in very powerful. It was like the whole earth was shaking. The demon was so big and strong. And he came in front of Krishna and Balaram. And with his hind legs, he kicked Balaram in the chest.
Danuka 就是有着庞大的身躯。然后他跑动的时候，让整个地球都大地的位置晃动。他就这样一下猛烈的冲了过来，跑到 Krishna Balarama 跟前，就用他的后腿踢了 Krishna 的前胸。
So then Balaram didn't show any reaction, but then the demon came again to kick him. This time Balaram grabbed his hind legs and he whirled him around very fast.And Balaram whirled him around. The demon gave up his life. And then Balaram threw the body of the big ass into the top of the tree.
我刚才说错了，应该是 Balarama。这个驴魔就踢了 Balarama 的前胸，然后 Balarama 就一下子抓起这个驴子的腿，后腿就开始猛烈的抡了起来，飞速的把它抡到了抡起来，然后这个驴魔一下就丧命了。这样，巴拉拉玛又把他一下扔到了一棵大树的树顶上。
And then all the other ass demons, all the friends of Danuka, they all came, and Krishna and Balaram killed all these demons the same way.
候呢，德努卡苏拉的其他恶魔朋友也都冲了过来，然后 Krishna 和巴拉拉玛就抓起这些恶魔的后腿，就一一把他们都给杀死了。
So all these big ass demons, they were like clouds in the sky. They were all decorating the tops of the trees.
这些五彩缤纷的驴魔就好像天上的云朵一般，就装点着这塔拉万森林的树顶。
So then, now these demons are killed, then the forest is free, and then after a couple of days, all the people started to come back to the forest, and the birds also came back, and different animals, they all came, and they could enjoy the beauty of Talavan forest, and they could eat the fruits.
就这样，他们就杀死了这些恶魔，这样这个森林呢，又恢复了往日的美丽。所有的这些动物还有鸟类，他们也都纷纷的又重新进入到这个塔拉万森林当中，森林又恢复了它的美丽，然后又结出了丰硕的果实。
And then Narada Muni says, in the evening, with the coming of night, then Krishna would meet with the women of Braja. He would come back from herding the cows at the end of the day.And he'd come home to Vrindavan, and all the ladies would come out to welcome their children coming home from the forest.
Narada Muni 又描述说，一到了夜晚 ，Krishna 就会和 Vrindavan 的那些女士们一起上演他们的逍遥时光。因为到了晚上的时候呢，所有那些 Vrindavan 的女士都纷纷从家门中走出来欢迎。
Krishna would come home with a peacock feather in his hair and wearing forest flowers for a garland, forest flowers and leaves from the forest, and he would have the powder from the dust of the feet of the cows, the dust that would be in his hair. And Krishna's playing on his flute and attracting everybody.
Krishna 头插着孔雀羽毛，他也就是浑身上下呢，用森林的那些鲜花还有嫩叶装饰他自己。他身上还有着牛蹄扬起的尘土，他的头上就有着这个孔雀羽毛的装饰。他吹奏着他的笛子。
So the women of Vrindavan would feel relief when Krishna would come home in the evening.They would feel separation all day, but when he would come home in the evening, then they would feel great relief that Krishna has come back to them.
Vrindavan 的女子看到 Krishna 从Vrindavan 的森林当中返回家中，她们都舒了一口气，因为白天呢，她们都深深地感到与他的分离之情。
Narada Muni says he's unable to describe the intimate dealings between Krishna and his devotees. He said beyond his words to describe.
Narada Muni 说 Krishna 和他的朋友和那里的居民的所有之间的交往是难以用语言形容的。
But it could also be that Narada Muni is afraid that if he would speak too much about it, he will become so ecstatic.That he'll lose control of himself. It will give him too much ecstasy, and he won't be able to speak anymore.
Narada Muni 也担心，如果他说的太多的话，他就会狂喜之情就会压倒他，他就无法自抑，以至于他不能再讲下去。
So he just offers obeisances with a few words.
因此他仅仅用只言片语来向主 Krishna 顶礼。
Then Narada Muni speaks about how Krishna gave mercy to the demon Kaliya who came into the water of the Yamuna and poisoned the Yamuna.
接下来 Narada Muni 又描述了主 Krishna 给予卡利亚蛇的仁慈，卡利亚蛇就进入到 Yamuna 河水当中污染了那里的河水。
Yeah, this demon Kaliya, in the form of a great serpent, had come into the water of the Yamuna and poisoned all the water, and the cows had come there and the cowherd boys, and they'd all been poisoned by the water. They'd all actually died, but Krishna glanced over them and brought them back to life.
这条卡利亚巨蟒进入到杨木的河水当中，它释放出巨大的毒液，以至于那来到杨木的河来喝水的母牛和那些牧牛同朋友都因为这个毒水而死去了。但是主 Krishna 用他超然的一瞥，使他们又恢复了生命。
Yeah, this demon Kaliya was such a rascal that he held Krishna in his coils. When Krishna entered into the water of the Yamuna, the Kaliya serpent bound him up in his coils, his dirty, horrible coils, bound up Lord Krishna and held him in his grip for a long time in the bottom of the Yamuna.
竟然就是把 Krishna 紧紧的缠了起来，他的身体是这么肮脏，这么恐怖，然后他就紧紧的长时间的把主 Krishna 紧紧的裹在了杨木那河的河底。
Yeah, all the people of Vrindavan were all on the bank of the Yamuna, and they saw Krishna there in the clutches of Kaliya. And they thought, Krishna's finished, Krishna's got dead, the demon's killing. He's held him in the bottom of the Yamuna for a long time. Krishna must be dead. And all the people of Vrindavan and Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, they wanted to go into the Yamuna, wanted to get in there to try to save Krishna, to free him from the Kaliya serpent. But Balaram wouldn't let anybody go in. Balaram said, no, it's okay, it's all right, just wait. Krishna's going to fix this demon. Don't worry. And Krishna, after a long time, Krishna broke out from the coils of the Kaliya serpent. And then Krishna danced on the hoods of that serpent, kicking them with his heels. And it says, it's only because of this Kaliya serpent, he had many wives, and these wives offered very nice prayers to Lord Krishna and worshipped Krishna. So Krishna didn't kill Kaliya. But actually, Kaliya was the most fortunate soul because he got the dust from Krishna's lotus feet on his head. That dust from Krishna's feet is the greatest treasure. Even Anantashesha has difficulty to describe the glory, the mercy which Kaliya got. But the wives of Kaliya, somehow they managed to describe it in their humble prayers. They offered prayers to Krishna, and they described the mercy their husband had received.
But 他的这个财富的仁慈，他们向主 Krishna 祈祷，荣耀了他的仁慈，并且描述他们丈夫得到了巨大的好运。
They could understand their husband must have been very sinful to get the body of that big snake, poison snake.
他们知道，他们说他们的丈夫得到了这个一个巨蟒的身体，一定是做了罪孽深重。
And they just wondered how is it, how would, what did he do to be so fortunate to get the lotus feet of Krishna on his head?
但是他们又奇怪，到底他们的丈夫曾经做过哪些活动才这么幸运？哪些幸运的活动使得他的头上能够顶着 Krishna 的莲花足？
And the because the marks of Krishna's feet were put onto the heads of Kaliya serpent, Krishna told Kaliya that now wherever you go, Garuda will not harm you because he will see my footprints on your head.
现在呢，卡利亚蛇的头顶就有着 Krishna 的足印的印记，所以主 Krishna 告诉。命令卡利亚蛇说道：“现在你不用害怕嘎鲁达，因为他一看到你头上的我的莲花族的足迹，就不会伤害你。”
So then, the next pastime Narada Muni describes is how Krishna saved the his friends, the cowherd boys, from the forest fire.
接下来 ，Narada Muni 描述了。Krishna 是如何把他的牧牛童朋友从森林大火当中拯救出来
？Actually, there were two occasions where there were fires in the Vrindavan forest.
实际上，在 Vrindavan 森林当中曾经发生过两次森林火灾。
So, like in because in the summer it's very hot and very dry.So when it's very dry, then it's easy to get the fire in the forest. Just the bamboo rubs together, and they get a spark, and then the fire comes.
实际上，到了夏季，这个天气既干燥又酷热，所谓森林很容易着火，就像竹子相互摩擦，会迸发出火星。
So the second fire was even more amazing than the first fire.At the second fire, Krishna told his friends, just close your eyes and I will save you.
实际上第二次森林大火比第一次森林大火更令人惊讶，因为主 Krishna 告诉他的朋友，你们闭上眼睛，我就能救你们。
And when they closed their eyes, they found them, Krishna moved them to another forest.
闭上眼睛的时候，发现主 Krishna 把他们转移到了另外一座森林。
Another pastime took place in the forest was playing with the cowherd boys. Sometimes they would wrestle with each other, and sometimes Krishna would be defeated by some Shridam, and he would have to carry Shridam on his back.
下一个消。时光是主 Krishna 和他的朋友们摔跤，当他主 Krishna 被摔打败的时候，他必须要扛着背着 Shridam。
At that time, one demon came, Pralambasura, and he took the form just like a cowherd boy. And he thought he wanted to kill Krishna.But he thought, Krishna is very powerful. Maybe I'll start with Balaram. I think I'll first kill Balaram and then I'll get Krishna. So he was wrestling with Balaram. And Balaram defeated him. So Pralambasura had to carry. Oh, no, what the? Oh, Balaram carried Pralambasura.
叫 Pralambasura， 他就把自己 给变成一个牧牛童的形象，就开始跟，就开始就想要杀死 Krishna， 但是他想，也许我应该先对付 Balaram， 然后如果 Balaram 杀死 Balaram 之后呢，我再来对付 Krishna， 所以他就跟 Balaram 摔跤，最后就把 Balaram 给打败了，所以 Balaram 必须得背着他。
No, actually, as I remember it, Pralambasura was carrying Balaram. Pralambasura got defeated. The one who gets defeated, they have to carry the other. So Balaram won, and Pralambasura was carrying Balaram. And he tried to carry Balaram away, run away. But Balaram became very heavy, and Pralambasura, he had to show his real form as a demon. So then Balaram killed him.
但实际上呢，是 Balaram 赢了，所以 Pralambasura 呢，他就得背着 Balaram 往前跑。但是他觉得 Balaram 越来越重，所以呢，恶魔就扛不动他了。最后 Balaram 就一拳就杀死了恶魔。
Then it comes to the rainy season, and during the rainy season, the cowherd boys, they take rest underneath the trees. They protect themselves from the rain by hiding, being under the trees, and sometimes they'll go in the cave of on Govardhan Hill.
雨季来临了，这些牧牛童朋友，他们放牧的时候呢，有时候会躲到树下或者山洞来避雨。
So then, of course, after the rainy season, then forest becomes very beautiful. Many flowers come out and becomes very nice and green after the hot summer, which is very dry. Then the rain comes, and then with the rain, everything is nourished and everything grows beautifully.
那到了雨季呢，森林当中呢，就是鲜花竞开，因为到夏季的时候呢，一切都很干燥，而雨水就是滋润了大地，一切都郁郁葱葱，美丽非凡。
So Narada Muni prays, when will I be able to see with my own eyes the way Krishna dresses in the forest?
Narada Muni 祈祷道，我的眼睛什么时候才能看见 Krishna 装扮他自己的美丽的景象呢？
Krishna plays a flute, and the sound of the flute steals away the hearts of everyone.
当 Krishna 吹奏他的笛子的时候，美丽的笛音就偷走了所有人的心意。
Krishna enters the forest like he's the greatest of dancers.
Krishna 进入森林的时候，就好像是最伟大的舞蹈家。
And he enters the Vrindavan forest, he marks the ground with his lotus feet. And he fills the holes of his flute with the nectar from his lips. So the gopis, they give the most beautiful analysis of the beauty of Krishna and the glories of Krishna.
Gopi 们就开始就分析了 Krishna 的美丽， Krishna 的荣耀。
The gopis are always praising Krishna, and they often talk about his flute.
Gopi 们他们总是在谈论Krishna, 以及弹了 Krishna 的笛子。
Because when Krishna plays on the flute, that sound of this flute enters their heart, and they become stunned, and they don't know what to do. They become overwhelmed, ecstatic love for Krishna.
因为当 Krishna 吹奏他的笛子的时候，优美的笛音就进入了到他们的心内心，他们就变得呆若木鸡，无所适从，因为他们已经被对 Krishna 狂喜的爱征服了。
And even the trees, which usually don't move, they begin to tremble with ecstasy, hearing the sound of Krishna's flute.
而通常那些静立不动的树木，因为听到 Krishna 的笛音，也开始在狂喜当中颤抖起来。
So the sound of Krishna's flute, this is the essence of Krishna's sweetness.
因此 ，Krishna 的笛音是他的甜美的精华。
That could attract people all over the creation.
它可以吸引所有创造当中的生物的心。
And especially in the autumn season, in the autumn season, it's when the attraction between the opposite sex is the strongest, because it's, you know, it's just after the rainy season's over, and the forest becomes very beautiful, so people want enjoyment. So the gopis,They become very attracted by the sound of Krishna's flute.
到了秋季，生物它们都会情欲高涨，因为丰硕的雨水呢，就使得文达文的森林变得美丽异常。这时候呢，那些牧牛姑娘就当这时候所有的生物它们就想要享受。而那些牧牛姑娘就会被 Krishna 的笛音所吸引。
Then the next pastime Narada Muni describes is Krishna stealing the clothes of the young girls.
Narada Muni 描述的下一个夕阳时光是 Krishna 偷取年轻牧牛姑娘的衣服。
He climbed on top of a kadamba tree at the bank of the Yamuna, and the young gopis were in the Yamuna taking bath.And Krishna climbed up on the tree and he took their clothes.
Krishna 呢就爬到亚木那河岸边一棵卡当巴树高高的树上。他因为当时呢牧牛姑娘年轻的姑娘们正在那里沐浴，而 Krishna 呢就拿着他们的衣服爬到了树上。
So at this time, Krishna was able to speak joking words with all the gopis.He told them, he said, you're taking bath naked. And so this is an offense against the demigods.
Krishna 就开始跟他们开玩笑。他说，你们赤身裸体在河水当中沐浴，这是对半神的不敬。
So he told the gopis that you have to counteract your sin. You have to come and you have to offer obeisances and place your...Join your two palms together above your head and offer obeisances. Then I'll give you back your clothes.
Krishna 说，你们现在必须要抵消你们的冒犯，你们都一一上前过来，然后顶拜，你们双手合十放在头顶，这样呢，我才能把你们的衣服还给你们。
So this actually this time the gopis are doing.Special vow is called Katyayani Vrat. They worship Katyayani to get a husband.
在此期间，牧牛姑娘们她们正在遵守着一个誓言，叫 Katyayani 誓言。她们崇拜着 Katyayani 女神，想获得一位如意郎君。
And of course, all the gopis they want to get Krishna for a husband.
所有的牧牛姑娘的心愿都是希望 Krishna 成为他们的丈夫。
So Krishna is arranging that they can all get him for the husband because by stealing their clothes, they have to come naked before Krishna. Now a woman can only be naked before her husband, not before any other man.
Krishna 实际上是安排了所有这些牧牛姑娘满足他们的心愿，因为他就让他们赤身裸体。因为只有一位女子，她只有在自己的丈夫面前才可以这样去做。
So in this way, Krishna was satisfying the desire of the gopis that they could become like Krishna's wives.
Krishna 就以这种方式就满足了这些年轻姑娘的心愿，她们希望成为 Krishna 的妻子。
So when Krishna saw the gopis, how they were so embarrassed, they had to come before him naked, then Krishna was very satisfied by their pure love.
当 Krishna 看到这些年轻姑娘站在他们面前那害羞的样子，他感到心满意足，他对他们纯粹的父爱感到很满意。
One by one, they got back their clothes, and they all accepted Krishna like a husband.
他们一一上前，就拿回了自己的衣服，他们全都接受 Krishna 作为自己的丈夫。
Then the next pastime,described by Narada Muni, is begging food from the wives of the brahmanas.
Narada Muni 描述的下一个消失光是 Krishna 向婆罗门的妻子那里乞讨食物。
Actually, the first they begged from the brahmanas. There were some brahmanas there who were doing a sacrifice, and they had a lot of food prepared for the yajna. And the cowherd boys.And with Krishna and Balaram, they had not taken breakfast that morning. They were very hungry. So they thought, we will go and ask these brahmanas for some food. So when they went there, well, Krishna and Balaram didn't go, but the cowherd boys went. And they were asking in the name of Krishna and Balaram, can we give some food? But the brahmanas just ignored them.
Krishna.那天早晨呢，有一些婆罗门他们正在准备一场火祭，所以他有很多的食物，要在这个祭祀当中被供奉。当天早上 ，Krishna 和巴拉拉姆还牧牛童朋友并没有吃早餐，所以他们都饥肠辘辘。但是 Krishna 和巴拉拉姆没有亲自过来乞讨食物。而是那些牧牛童朋友，他们以 Krishna Balaram 的名义来乞讨食物，但是这些婆罗门全都对于这些牧牛童的请求就置之不理，熟视无睹。
So the cowherd boys came back, they were very disappointed. The brahmanas didn't pay any attention to them, they just ignored them. But Krishna told them, he said, well, that's the nature of begging.That sometimes people give, sometimes they don't. So then Krishna told them, go and ask the wives of the brahmanas.
So these 牧牛童朋友们就两手空空的就回来了。但是呢 ，Krishna 和巴拉拉姆就安慰他们说，这就是乞讨的本性。有的时候你们会得到，乞讨者会得到，有时候他们什么一无所获，他又让他们去找婆罗门的妻子们讨要食物。
So when the cowherd boys went there to the wives of the brahmanas, they heard Krishna and Balaram were there. They were so happy, they grabbed all the food and they came running. They wanted to bring everything for Krishna and Balaram because they'd heard about Krishna and Balaram.And they thought, we're so fortunate, we want to meet Krishna and Balaram, we want to go and offer our obeisances to them.
当 这些婆罗门妻子一听说是 Krishna 和 Balaram 要讨要食物的时候，他们都非常的满心欢喜，心花怒放，他们都抓起食物就跑了过来，他们想把一切都献给 Krishna 和 Balaram， 因为他们都曾经之前听说过这个兄弟俩，他们就感到特别幸运，就想要和他们会面，向他们顶拜。
So when the ladies came to Krishna and Balaram, Krishna welcomed them, and he told them, "Oh, you're very fortunate, ladies. Please sit down and be comfortable." And the Krishna says to them, "What can I do for you?" You have come here to see me. It's very nice.
当 Krishna 看到了这些婆罗门的妻子们过来，他就用言辞欢迎他们说：“哦，请过来，欢迎你们都是如此幸运的女士，请坐下，舒适的坐下来。我能为你们做些什么呢？你们能来真是太好了。”
And then Krishna, you know, the Brahmana's wives, they thought, because we've brought everything to Krishna and Balaram, this was actually meant for our husbands. We've left our husbands. And they thought, we will just stay with Krishna. We don't want to go back to our husbands. We will just stay with Krishna. But Krishna told them, no, you don't need to do that. You can go back to your husbands. Your husbands will take you back.
这些婆罗门的妻子，他们就心想，我们这些准备的这些食物本来是要拿去给我们的丈夫的，但是现在呢，我们离开了自己的丈夫，然后他们就想留在Krishna和Balaramna那里不回去了，但是Krishna告诉他们，不，你们回去吧，你们的丈夫会接受你们的。
Yeah, Krishna said, not only your husbands will accept you, but also your father and your brothers and your sons and your relatives. He said, I will personally tell them the situation. Don't worry.
Krishna said, 不仅你们的丈夫，你们的父亲、兄弟、儿子、亲戚都会接受你们的，我会亲自过去告诉他们。
And Krishna said, even the demigods will approve what you've done.
Krishna 还说，即便是半神人们，他们也会对你们的所作所为表示赞同。
Yeah, these wives of the brahmanas are called the Yagnapatnis. The Yagnapatnis, they had so much love for Krishna that they didn't think about their husbands or about their family. They just wanted to go and serve Krishna.
这些婆罗门的妻子叫Yagnapatni，他们是如此的深爱Krishna，他们根本就不想他们的丈夫，他们只是想着怎么去服务Krishna。
And even their husbands could understand the special love which their wives had for Krishna.
他们的丈夫也明白自己的妻子对Krishna所怀着怀有的特殊的爱恋。
And these brahmanas, they regretted that they didn't have the love or the devotion which their wives had.
这些婆罗门感到后悔，他们没有像自己的妻子那样爱Krishna和Balarama。
The brahmanas were saying, we don't know what our wives did in the past to have so much love for Krishna. They said, our wives, they never studied any scripture. They never practiced celibacy. They never did any of the things we did, but they have so much love for Krishna.
他们这些婆罗门说，我们不知道我们的妻子以前曾经做过什么事情，以至于这么爱Krishna。他们也没有像我们这样研读经典，也并没有去修习真守。但是他们以前不知道他们以前做过什么，使得他们如此的爱Krishna。
The Brahmanas, they were not able to show that kind of mood which their wives had for Krishna. So they appreciated that their wives had so much Krishna consciousness, not like them.
这些婆罗门们就对于他们的妻子对Krishna、Balarama的心态感到非常的欣赏，他们对于他们妻子展示出来的Krishna知觉感到很赞赏。
These brahmanas, they were just attached to doing ritualistic ceremonies, and they had not understood the real purpose behind all these rituals.
这些婆罗门仅仅是依附着那些仪式仪轨，他们并不理解这些仪式背后的目的何在。
But these wives of the brahmanas, they had developed their love for Krishna, and they had developed pure love for Krishna, which was able to, their love for Krishna would free them from the attachment to family life.
但是这些婆罗门的妻子们却发展起了对Krishna纯洁的爱, 以至于他们使他们免除了对家庭生活的依恋。
So Krishna also accepted the food of the brahmana's wives. Took the because they were bringing the food, so Krishna was he accepted it.
Krishna 就这样这样接受了婆罗门妻子带来的食物。
And Krishna distributed that food to all the cowherd boys, and Krishna also took some of the preparations himself.
Krishna 还把这些食物派发给了牧牛童朋友们，他自己也亲口品尝了这些食物。
So just imagine, you cook, you make something, you cook something, Krishna personally comes and eats it. That's the perfection of your life.
你可以想象一下，你做了一些食物，然后 Krishna 亲自过来就吃下了这些食物，这就是人生的完美。
So now, next, Narada Muni is going to speak about Govardhan Hill, how Krishna offered worship to Govardhan Hill, and how he held the hill with his left hand for 7 days and nights.
接下来 Narada Muni 又描述了 Krishna.就是如何崇拜高山山，并且用他的左手举起了高山山7天7夜。
And by doing this, he was able to enjoy the company of all the cowherd people, all the gopis and gopas. They were all able to be together for 7 days and nights.
就这样 ，Krishna 可以享受和所有那些牧牛郎、牧牛童、gopi、gopa 他们在一起。连续地待了7天7夜的时间。
And after this, then Indra, of course, was humbled, and he came and begged forgiveness from Lord Krishna.
这个事件之后 ，Indra 呢就感到就他的骄傲就被击败了，所以他过来恳求得到 Krishna 的宽恕。
And at that time, he also came with Surabhi cow, and Surabhi cow, she also came to thank Krishna for saving all the cows, because when Krishna picked up the Govardhan Hill, all the cows also came under the Govardhan Hill, so they were also protected. So Surabhi came to thank Krishna.
Indra 也带来了 Surabhi 母牛也希望感谢主 Krishna 举起高山山，保护了 Vrindavan 的所有的
And so at that time, they told Krishna, you are actually Indra, because Indra means king. They said, you're the real king, not this Indra. They said to Krishna, you are the real king.
Surabhi 就称赞主 Krishna, 说你才是真正的 Indra. Indra 的意思就是国王，而不是这个 Indra.
And they give Krishna a special bath.Surabhi offered her milk to bathe Krishna, and then Indra brought water from the heavenly planets, from Mother Ganga and the heavenly planets, and they used it all to bathe Krishna, to give him a special bath.
Surabhi 母牛呢又给予 Krishna 一个特殊的沐浴，用他的牛奶奶汁。Indra 呢也从天堂带来了恒河，他们就一起用 Surabhi 母牛的奶汁和恒河水为 Krishna 举行了特殊的沐浴仪式。
So all the people of Vrindavan, after Krishna had protected them like this from the wrath of Indra, they were all so happy, they felt so much love for Krishna, and they'd been with Krishna for 7 days and nights. They never felt any hunger or any tiredness. They'd just been looking at Krishna.For 7 days and nights.
Vrindavan 的居民呢，所有的生物都感激 Krishna 把他们从 Indra 的盛怒当中解救了出来。他们非常的爱 Krishna， 因为连续7天7夜，他们都跟 Krishna 待在一起。他们既没有感到饥饿，也没有感到疲累。他们对 Krishna 的爱就增加了。
So after Krishna picked up Govardhan Hill.All the people of Vrindavan, they were a bit confused about who is Krishna that he can do these amazing things. So they came to Nanda Maharaj to ask him about this. that who is this son of yours that he's so amazing, he could kill all these demons and now he's picked up the Govardhan Hill.
在 Krishna 举起 Govardhan 山的事件之后， Vrindavan 的居民们都感到困惑不解，这个小孩子到底是谁呀？他所做的这一切的事件都是那么令人惊讶，所以他们就来到南达大君跟前，向他提出疑惑：这你的儿子到底是谁？他杀死了这诸多的恶魔，又连续举起了 Golden 山。
So Nanda Maharaj told them what Garga Muni had said at the time of Krishna's birth, at the time of his name-giving ceremony. You know, after Krishna's birth, they had the name-giving ceremony and Garga Muni came to the home and he told about Krishna's identity.
Nanda 大君就向这些居民们描述了 Garga Muni 的在 Krishna 的命名仪式上所说的话。因为当 Krishna 诞生之后呢， Garga Muni 来到了他南达大君家中，就告知了他们 Krishna 的身份。
And he told them that your child is like Narayan, and there will be many demons, many obstacles, many people will come and try to trouble him, but he will overcome all the problems, all the obstacles.
他说，你的孩子会像主 Narayan 一样，会有很多的恶魔，还有障碍。但是呢 ，Krishna 的会一一杀死这些恶魔，并且克服所有这些障碍。
So when the people of Vrindavan heard this from Nanda Maharaj, then they were very happy, and they worshipped Nanda Maharaj and Lord Krishna. They showed them great respect.
当们他们居民听到他的这番话后，感到非常的高兴，便崇拜了南达大君和 Krishna。
So Krishna satisfied the Brijbasi people. He told them, he spoke very nicely to them. He said, don't be embarrassed to be related to me. He said, you don't have to praise me, but just if you have some affection for me, just think of me as your relative.Krishna said, I'm not God, and I'm not a demigod, I'm simply your family member. So just think of me like that.
Krishna 就对 Brajabasi 们说，你们不要感到难为情，你们也不需要赞美我，你们只需要像亲戚那样爱我一样。就可以了，你们不要把我当成神，也不要把我视为半神，你们只需要把我当成家人那样一直想着我就可以。
Krishna likes to have just that pure loving relationship. The people of Vrindavan, they just think of him as their son or as their friend or as their lover. They don't think of him as God.
Krishna 只会被这种纯爱的关系感到满足，他只是希望 Krishna 那边的居民们把他当成自己的儿子、朋友、爱侣，不要把他当成神。
So then, Narada Muni says he's not able to describe the wonderful pastime of how Krishna showed Vaikuntha.To all the people of Vrindavan.
Nanda Maharaj 又说描述说，他很难来描述 Krishna 向这些 Vrindavan 的 Brajabasi 们展示 Vaikuntha 的情景的小时光。
Krishna wanted to show the spiritual world to the people of Vrindavan, and when they saw the spiritual world, they thought it was like Vrindavan.
Vrindavan
So they saw actually there's no difference between Vrindavan on this planet and Vrindavan in the spiritual world. And then Krishna rescued Nanda Maharaj from Varuna's kingdom. Varuna, the god of the sea, Nanda Maharaj had been arrested but taken away by some servants of Varuna because he was taking bath early in the morning. And the people, the servants of Varuna, they arrested Nanda Maharaj and took him to Varuna's kingdom. So Krishna had to go and get Nanda Maharaj back. And when Krishna went to Varuna's kingdom, then Varuna, he worships Krishna, he offers respect to Krishna. Nanda Maharaj was amazed. He thought, how is it Varuna is, he's so powerful and he's worshipping my son Krishna. But Varuna understood that Krishna is the Supreme Lord, and Varuna was very respectful to Krishna, and he immediately gave Nanda Maharaj back to Krishna, and he apologized to Krishna. I'm sorry, my servants are very foolish. They should not have taken your father.
当Nanda大军呢看到Varuna崇拜他的儿子之后的感到非常的惊讶，Varuna是这么有力量的一个半神人，竟然这么对他的儿子彬彬有礼，尊崇有加，而且崇拜他，把他当成至尊，Varuna知道Krishna是至尊主，所以对非常的尊敬他，然后并立刻还回了，Nanda大军，并且表示道歉，我的徒人们太愚蠢了，他们本来不应该这样做。
Okay, so we're going to stop here. Now Narada Muni just wants to increase Gop Kumar's devotion and affection for Lord Krishna. He wants to describe the wonderful qualities of Krishna so that Gop Kumar will be more inspired to go there to Vrindavan and to be with Krishna in Vrindavan.
Narada Muni 描述了这一种种的消时光， 目的就是为了增加Gopakumar对Krishna的奉献和爱心， 种种的Krishna这些奇妙的品质， 他就希望Gopakumar受到激励， 能够去Vrindavan去遇见Krishna。
Okay, any questions?
第一个问题是来自于淡然一笑， 为什么巴拉拉玛杀驴魔，Krishna不杀，有什么意义吗？
Yes, very good. Good question. Who asked this question?
那就是这个网名叫淡然一笑。淡然一笑。
Interesting name. Can you use the Mingsa? So, there's a reason for this. Because this Denuka demon, he represents ignorance. And Balaram, he's the spiritual master. Balaram is the original spiritual master. So the spiritual master destroys the ignorance so that we can awaken our attachment and love for Krishna.
而巴拉拉玛是原始的灵性导，原初的灵性导师，所以灵性导师他就是摧毁了愚昧无知，使得人们唤醒对 Krishna 的依附和爱恋。
So it's like that. Yes.
Next one is from喜宝。 顶拜咕噜和老师们，这段时间我通过给一些长辈和老人阅读薄伽梵歌， 圣典博加瓦坛讲昆士那故事，老人们第一次听说灵魂的知识，他们让我结合通俗易懂的中国传统文化民间故事讲述昆士那的教导，并且有人问，第一，老人们的问题是，如果现在人老了，记不住那么多深奥的哲学，但是尽量吃素，尽量多念诵圣名，能不能保证临终平静的离去，下辈子还做人，重新学习，重新继续好好学习昆士那知觉呢？So this obeisance guru and teachers, this period, I read Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and Krishna Katha to some old people, and they have heard about the soul for the first time, and they asked me to relate Krishna's teaching with the tradition, Chinese tradition culture, and those folks story. Beside that, they also raised a question, two questions. The first one is because now they are old, they cannot remember so many deep knowledge, philosophy, but they can try to be vegetarian and try to chant more holy name. Is there any insurance that at the final times they can leave the body peacefully, and the next life they can continue to have a human body and continue to learn Krishna consciousness?
Yes, definitely. If they're chanting the holy name and they develop affection for Krishna, they can go back to Godhead. They don't need to come back and take another human body. They can get free of birth and death.
肯定是可以的。如果他们唱诵圣名，发展对昆士那的爱，他们甚至都可以回归神首，他们无需再回来得到另外一具人体生命，他们甚至可以摆脱生死轮回。
But guaranteed, at least you'll get the human birth and you can continue your devotional service.
但是可以肯定的一点，他们是无疑可以再获得一具人体生命，继续做奉献服务。
You may even be so fortunate that you can go back to Godhead.
甚至是可以，非常的幸运，甚至幸运的得以回归神首。
You just have to develop your affection, your love for Krishna.
只需要发展，对 Krishna 的爱。
Yes, what's the second question?
Second question, 现在还有人问，现在年龄那么大才第一次知道 Krishna, 如果现在认认真真念诵圣名，尽量心里全部都是 Krishna, 有没有可能死后也能够回归灵性世界呢？
Yeah, I said, yeah, you can go back to Godhead. If you chant the holy name, chanting the holy name is the process for this age. If you chant the holy name and you become attached to Krishna and remember Krishna at the end of life, then you go to be with Krishna.
唱诵圣名是这个年代的大法，就是通过唱诵名可以发展对 Krishna 的依附，能够使人们能够记住 Krishna, 这样死后呢就可以跟 Krishna 待在一起了。下一个是，该是智敏，顶拜咕噜，顶拜在场的所有奉献者。那些妻子真幸运，比他们婆罗门的丈夫都爱 Krishna。我们怀着真诚的愿望，也能这样吗 ？So those obeisance guru.And obeisance to all devotees present, and those wives, they are so lucky that they love Krishna even more than their Brahmin husband. If we have a sincere desire in our heart, Can we also be like them?
Definitely.
肯定可以。
Yeah, you should try to be like them. They're very wonderful devotees.
你们应该像他们那样，他们是优秀的奉献者。And
so we want to follow in the footsteps of these great devotees.
我们希望能够追寻这些伟大奉献者的足迹。
This is why these pastimes are all told to us, so that we can become inspired to follow the example of all these great devotees.
正是由于这个原因，所以才讲给我们讲述的这些逍遥时光，以便激励我们，也追随他们的典范和榜样。
If when we sing the songs of, like, if you sing the song about Vrindavan, you know that song, Braja Mahamrita, Jai Radhe, Jai Krishna, Jai Vrindavan. There are also things that they sing about the wives of the Kaliya serpent, and then they sing about the Yajna Patnis, the wives of the Brahmanas. They're all glorified in these pastimes, and they're very famous in Vrindavan.
您知道那个文达文的荣耀那首歌曲吗？在那首歌曲当中就描述了这个卡利亚蛇的妻子，还有亚迪亚帕尼们，就是婆罗门的妻子们，这个歌曲呢就荣耀了 Krishna 的那些圣名，他们也得到了荣耀。So
these wives of the Brahmanas, they had developed some, we don't know how they got the love for Krishna. Maybe they just heard about Krishna in the marketplace. When they would go to market, they would hear from the other people. They would all be talking about Krishna. So they'd heard about Krishna from other people. And so when they heard that Krishna and Balaram had come and was right there, wow, they were so eager to go there, to see Krishna and Balaram, and to surrender to him.
我们不知道这些婆罗门的妻子们是怎么发展起对 Krishna 的爱的。也许呢，他们去市场，然后听到市场，听别人就讲到了 Krishna， 说起了 Krishna 和 Balarama， 他们就一下发展起这种渴望，想要去见 Krishna Balarama， 去臣服他们。
So they're like examples of people who kripa siddha. They get perfection by mercy. They didn't do sadhana siddha, but they got mercy by some. They got special mercy, became perfect.
他们是属于那个 kripa siddha, kripa siddhi 那种类型。他们并不是 sadhana siddha。 通过规范修行得到完美，而是通过得到特殊的仁慈，得以完美。
So yes, be like the wives of the Brahmanas. Be attached to Krishna. Don't just think of your husband.
是的，可以像那些婆罗门的妻子那样，就是依附 Krishna， 不要依附自己的丈夫。
Of course, don't neglect your husband, but remember your husband is also a part of Krishna.
当然不要忽视你们自己的丈夫，但是你们丈夫是 Krishna 的所属部分。
Okay.
下一个问题是，海参崴俄罗斯的 Rajarani Devdasi。 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj， 请接受我卑微顶拜，所有荣耀归于圣文帕帕德。请问奉献者年轻姑娘们可以崇拜塔提亚尼女神吗？为了得到好的丈夫，奉献者的丈夫，因为在圣文帕帕德的书里面有描述这个月，在奉献者的日历上也有描述这位女神日子开始。
Well, you want to do Kalyani Vrat, you have to take bath in the Yamuna early in the morning.
你如果想要遵守这个卡特亚尼这个誓言的话，必须得每天清早在亚木那河中沐浴才行。 Now the second question, 第二个问题是, 也是这些奉献者的。 如果奉献者歌颂 Kirtan好, 有积极周期安排神圣恩帕帕德的书, 但是自己不读书, 不读帕帕德的书, 也不参加联谊, 这样的奉献者能离开物质世界吗? If some devotees can have very nice kirtan, they can do very nice kirtan, and they also actively arrange.
还是说积极的派书？
Oh.
说奉献者积极的派书，但是自己不读书。
也不参加联谊。自己不读书, they don't read the books, they don't go to association, but they will distribute the book.
是这样?
Yes, yes. 问题是什么?
他问题是, can they leave material world?
Well, if they have pure love for Krishna, then they can.
如果他们对Krishna有纯粹的爱是可以的。
The qualification is that you've developed some love for Krishna.
这个资格是对Krishna有爱。
You want to get, when you distribute books, you want to think of Krishna, you want to see Krishna in everyone. And that's why you're giving them the book.
当派书的时候是希望能在每个人的心中能够见到Krishna, 所以呢才派书。
Yeah, you get benefit, you get great benefit by distributing the books. But you should also read them.
派书是能得到好处的,但是同时也应该读书。
Are you chanting? Chanting is very important.
他们有没有念诵呢?念诵是非常重要的。
The process in the Kali Yuga is to chant the holy name.
在Kali年代的程序是唱诵圣名。
Distributing books is very good. You get a lot of mercy by doing that. But that mercy means you get taste for chanting the holy name and you get more attraction for Krishna. And Prabhupada also told us, he said, I didn't just write the books for you to sell, I wrote the books for you to read them.
奉献者说，我写书呢，不是为了让你们去派，不仅仅让你们派的，而且是让你们要读的。
When you read the book and you appreciate the knowledge, then you'll be more enthusiastic to distribute the book because you'll know the value of the book.
当你们读了这些书，并且呢，能够欣赏到书当中的这些知识的时候，就会更有。
更有动力去派书，能够意识到这个书的价值。OK。下一个问题还是来自淡然一笑，后天是博家梵歌显现日，做什么活动能取悦博家梵歌？
You can read the whole Bhagavad Gita. 可以阅读整部《博伽梵歌》。
Yes, it's a holy day. It's a special day. The day Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita, so you should also, you can recite. You get some people together and you read, start to read the whole Bhagavad Gita.
那个伯孝堂的显现日是一个神圣的日子，特殊的日子，可以找几个人一起来，诵读整部伯孝梵歌。
Usually, what we do, we will just chant the Sanskrit.
我们通常是只诵读梵文。
But the whole book, 18 chapters.
但是是要诵读整部十八章的整部梵文。
And somebody can give a class, somebody should give a class about the significance of Bhagavad Gita and the speaking of Bhagavad Gita.
也可以有人来讲课讲述这个伯伽梵歌的重要性，讲述有关于伯伽梵歌的事情。
Of course, that day is also Ekadasi, so you have to observe Ekadasi.
那天正好恰逢那 Ekadasi, 所以还要遵守 Ekadasi.
Don't take any grain or beans.
不食五谷，不食任何豆类。
Take Ekadasi prasadam.
只进食 Ekadasi 餐。
And if you can distribute a Bhagavad Gita, also very good.
而且如果您能派发出伯伽梵歌，那也是更好的。
They say that day, this day, I think it's on Friday, right? That day is the best, very best day to distribute Bhagavad Gita. And we say that we distribute more Bhagavad Gitas that day than any other day in the year.
实际上，就是周五，在周五这一天派发伯伽梵歌是最好的日子了。我们一般。就是在这一天派出的伯伽梵歌，就是比这一年当中任何一天派出的都多。
So devotees around the world are all planning, trying to distribute books at this time. This is the time of the Prabhupada Marathon, month of December. Try to distribute more books. And that particular day, when Krishna speaks Bhagavad Gita, is a very special day. You can distribute many Bhagavad Gita.
现在呢，全世界奉献者都在举行派出马拉松，就是十二月份。那么在这一天，正好是伯伽梵歌显现这天，是特殊的日子，可以派很多有关派出很多伯伽梵歌。
So anybody you know who doesn't have a Bhagavad Gita, give them the Bhagavad Gita.
如果你认识哪个人呢，他还没有伯伽梵歌，你就。派给他一本
《
伯伽梵歌》。
OK， 还有问题吗？
还有，下一个是来自 Draupadi Devadasi， 顶麦姑的莲花族，感谢主持人，牧牛童朋友和勾皮面对面，自然被 Krishna 吸引，能为 Krishna 服，我们看不到 Krishna。为了避免受物质自然属性影响，是不是应该时刻念诵圣名？还有下一部分，就是两个 two questions.
Okay, 第一个 translate.
Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, because the gopis and the gopals they can, face with Krishna, naturally they are attracted and can serve Krishna, but yet we cannot see Krishna. And in order to avoid being influenced by material nature, should we also constantly chant the holy name?
Oh, yes, we should constantly chant the holy name.
是的，是的，应该常常念诵圣名。
Lord Chaitanya said in the Shikshastikam, Kirtaniya Sadahari, always chant the holy name.
就 Chaitanya 在八训规当中就说的 Kirtaniya Sadahari, 要恒常的唱诵圣名。
And it said in the Kali Yuga, Kali Kali Namarupe Krishna Avatar, that Krishna comes in the Kali Yuga in the form of his holy name.
还有这个诗文，那就是主 Krishna 在卡里年代以他的圣名的形式降临。
So very important to constantly chant the holy name. You can feel Krishna's presence. You may not see Krishna, but you can feel Krishna's presence by the holy name.
所以唱诵主的圣 Krishna 圣名非常重要。你可以感知到 Krishna， 你可能看不见他，但是你可以通过唱诵圣名感知到他。Next part is 没有把 Krishna 和圣名真正的当作是没有区别的，那如何培养对 Krishna 的爱以至于不受打扰呢？ But I cannot treat the holy name and Krishna as the same, no difference. So how can I develop Krishna prema so that I cannot be affected by material nature?
No, the holy name and Krishna are the same. You have to understand there's no difference between Krishna and Krishna's name.
Krishna 的圣名和 Krishna 是一样的。您当明白 Krishna 和 Krishna 名字没有区别。
When your chanting becomes pure, then you'll see within the holy name there is also Krishna's form and there is Krishna's qualities and Krishna's pastimes.
当您的念诵达到纯粹的时候，您就可以看到在 Krishna 的圣名当中也有他的形象， Krishna 的品质，还有他的逍遥时光。
But because our chanting is not yet pure, you're thinking like this. You have to understand more about the holy name.
因为我们的念诵不纯粹，所以我们有这种想法。但是你要明白的时候，但是你要对 Krishna 的圣名有更多的理解力。
Everything is in the holy name.
圣名就蕴含了一切了。
You keep chanting, you will see Krishna one day. And if you keep reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Prabhupada said, when we read Srimad Bhagavatam, we can see Krishna in the pages of Srimad Bhagavatam.
只要继续的唱诵念诵就可以见到 Krishna。 还要阅读博家圣典博家瓦坛，圣帕帕德说过我们可以在圣典博家瓦坛的字里行间，在他的每一页当中都能见到 Krishna。
So you can develop love for Krishna by doing hearing and chanting。
所以通过聆听唱诵就能发展出爱。
It's not that Krishna has to be personal. Krishna is here, but we don't see him because our eyes are covered by Maya.
Krishna 就亲自就降临在那里，但是你见不到，因为我们的眼睛被 Maya 覆盖了。
Krishna's everywhere. He's within the heart. He's with you in every atom. So he knows everything. He sees everything.
Krishna 遍存万有，他在每个生物心中，在每个人心中，在每个原子，在每个原子当中，他无所不知，他也能看到一切。
Don't doubt.Krishna's there. He's watching you.
不要心存怀疑， Krishna 就在那里，他在观察着你。
But you're only thinking your child or your husband.
可是现在呢，你一门心思呢，都是想自己的孩子，自己的丈夫。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个问题。是 fairy， 顶拜 guru fairy， 顶拜 guru 现在都快四五十岁了还单身，想找奉献者结婚，没有合适的，我应该向 Krishna 祈祷赐予我一个好伴侣吗？还是应该像那个姑娘一样把 Krishna 当成丈夫就够了呢？
Translate.
Obeisance Guru, now I'm 40s and nearly 40, 50 years old, but still I'm single. I want to have a devotee to marry, but there is no suitable object. So should I also pray to Krishna to bestow me a good partner, or should I also those gopis and treat Krishna as my husband and be satisfied with that?
Yes, I think it would be much better to take Krishna for your husband and be satisfied for that.
是的，我觉得，我认为您把 Krishna 当成自己的丈夫，然后就心满意足就可以了。
Krishna will, if you take Krishna for a husband, he will never leave you.
如果你把 Krishna 当你丈夫，你 Krishna 永远不离开你。
And Krishna will be the best husband. He's very compassionate and kind, and he's always with you, and he can help you and give you good guidance.
And Krishna is 特别的，是最佳的丈夫。他特别仁慈，特别的善良。他可以跟你在一起，在帮助你，来指导您。
Because you're not so young now. It's not really very suitable to get married later in life.
因为您现在就是已经不年轻了，就是晚婚不太合适。
Right, married life is meant to have a child.
婚姻的意义就在于就是生孩子。But
you can't have a child now.
但是您现在已经不可能再有孩子了。So
there's not much purpose. It doesn't serve. It would be very difficult to get married because you're not accustomed to living with a man, and then some man comes along and you will start to live. If you live with them, and then the man will have habits different from you, and you will quarrel. You'll have difficulty to get along with each other. So many problems.
这时候结婚没有太大的意义，因为呢，就是男，比如说一个男子，他来了，他有自己的习惯，然后呢，你跟他生活在一起，但你们习惯不一样，就会争吵，然后相处起来也会有困难，就有问题层出不穷。
So actually, you take Krishna for your husband, that can be the best marriage. That's the best situation.
So you take Krishna as your husband, this is the best situation.
Or if you want, Krishna can also be your child.
Or if you want, Krishna can also be your child.
Sometimes people worship Krishna like that. Some people worship Krishna like a husband, and some people worship Krishna like their child. And as a child, then they will give special service, special worship to Krishna. Give the child milk and milk sweets and things which a child can eat.
有的人呢，把 Krishna 当成丈夫。 有的人把 Krishna 当成孩子，来给 Krishna 提供特殊的服务，崇拜 Krishna， 给他牛奶喝呀，给他甜品吃啊，给那些就是适合孩子吃的食物。
And then when you leave the body, then if Krishna's your son, Krishna will come and he will do the last rites, because the son is the one who's supposed to do the last rites when the father or mother dies.
这样呢，就在您离开躯体之际呢 ，Krishna 就会像儿子一样的来为您做最后的这个送别仪式，因为通常呢，当离开父母离开身体之后呢，是儿子来为父母养老，就是送终。 而因为到那时候呢，父母亲都已经离世了。
So there was one couple, nice devotee couple like that here in Bengal, and when they died, then the son came, Krishna. They had taken Krishna as their son. They had no, they didn't have any son, so they took Krishna as their son. And then when they died, Krishna did the funeral. He did the last rites.
所以在在孟加拉，就有曾经有一对夫妻，他们呢就把 Krishna 当成子儿子。后来呢，当他们离开躯体的时候呢，Krishna 就以儿子的身份来为他们举行了葬礼。
All right.
好，下一个是王文言 Akashadev Devka 顶拜咕噜，顶拜主持人，顶拜所有的奉献者，请问咕噜，什么样的爱是对 Krishna 纯粹的爱呢？
What kind of love is pure love for Krishna?
Yes.
So pure love for Krishna is whatever makes Krishna happy, that is our happiness. Even if our being unhappy and being broken-hearted, if that makes Krishna happy, that is our happiness.
对 Krishna 的纯爱就是无论什么能让 Krishna, 让 Krishna 快乐开心，那就是我们的幸福，甚至即便是让我们不开心不高兴，让我们感到心碎，只要是 Krishna 感到快乐，那就是我们的快乐。
We can learn from the people of Vrindavan how to love Krishna purely.
我们可以从 Vrindavan 的人民那里学习如何纯粹的去爱 Krishna。
That they only think of Krishna at every moment, every situation, they're only thinking of Krishna.
时时刻刻，他们在每一个处境当中，他们所思所想的唯有 Krishna.
So pure love means they don't want anything, they're not thinking about their own self, they're just thinking about Krishna.Pleasing Krishna.
纯粹的爱，纯洁的爱就是他们不想自己，他们只想 Krishna, 想的是怎么取悦 Krishna.
In the material world, love is very different. It's not pure, it's very motivated, very materialistic. We will say,You love me, you should love me. You know, we want people to give us love. But in spiritual world, in relation to Krishna, we give love without wanting anything in return.
在物质世界的爱是有很大的区别的。这个物质世界的爱是不纯洁的。是有动机的，但是物质的。只要你爱我，他们在物质世界想的就是你来爱我，你给我。而在灵性的跟 Krishna 的关系当中呢，是给予 Krishna 爱 Krishna， 而不求回报。
Material world, we will say love.I will love you, but give me the money. Just give me the money and I will love you. And so that's not pure love.
在物质世界呢，人们会说，你给我钱我就爱你，但这不是纯粹的爱。
But pure love for Krishna is to love Krishna all the time and without anything, without wanting anything in return from Krishna.
在纯粹的爱当中呢，就是一直不断的去爱 Krishna， 但是呢，并 并不指望 Krishna 回报。
Something will say, I will love Krishna if you give me a lot of money. I will love Krishna if you give me a long life, good health. I will love Krishna if you give me a happy home.
有的人说，如果Krishna 给我钱，我就爱 Krishna。如果他给我一个长寿的生活，我就爱他。如果他给我健康，我就爱他。如果他给我一个快乐家庭，我就爱 Krishna。
So that's not pure love. That's mixed love, mixed with our material desires.
这不是纯洁的爱，这是混杂的爱，是有着物质欲望。
So it's not an easy thing to develop that pure love.
要发展起这样的纯粹的爱是不是容易的事儿。
But gradually we can come to that stage by practice of Krishna consciousness.
但是通过修习 Krishna 之觉可以逐渐地达到这一阶段。
Hare Krishna, good day. 王文燕马大吉继续问，他说把这个家人朋友当作 Krishna 去爱，这样可以吗？
Is that sure?
把这个家人还有朋友当作 Krishna 去爱，可以吗？
We treat family members and friends.As Krishna and love them. We love them as Krishna. Is that okay?
Well, we should love all living entities as Krishna. They're part of Krishna, you see. We have to see Krishna in them.But at the same time, they're not equal to Krishna.
We should love all living entities, all living entities,
We just like we see the spiritual teacher like the representative of Krishna. So we know he's not Krishna, but at the same time, he represents Krishna.
有一个歌说，我们应该把导师像主对待灵性导师像对待至尊主那样，但是我们知道灵性导师并不是 Krishna.
So we're talking about our husband, our family members, our friends. We can't simply see them as Krishna, but we can see them as parts of Krishna, as spirit souls, as parts of Krishna.
是灵魂，他们不是 Krishna， 他们是 Krishna 的部分。
Right, we offer our love to Krishna. We surrender to Krishna. Are you going to surrender like that to all your friends and to all your family members? It's not going to be quite the same.
我们说要爱 Krishna， 臣服 Krishna， 但是您会。去臣服你的所有朋友，臣服的家人吗？他们和 Krishna 相当有不一样的。
At the same time, we see Krishna's in them. We understand Krishna is in them, but not that they are actually Krishna.
我们在他们心中看到 Krishna， 我们明白 Krishna 就在他们心中。但他们不是 Krishna。
So it's like our philosophy, Lord Chaitanya taught, one and different, inconceivably, simultaneously, one and different. They're one with Krishna, but at the same time, they're different from Krishna. So dealing with the family members and friends, and like, yeah, it's very nice to think of them as parts of Krishna. Yeah. Respecting them, honoring them, but you're not going to worship them like we worship Krishna. But at the same time, we want to keep nice relationships, keep the proper mood, not to argue with them, not to quarrel and fight with them, to respect them and deal with them nicely, honor them. Knowing that they're part of Krishna, but at the same time different from Krishna. You know, because if you think they're Krishna, at the same time you see them sit and eat meat, and they smoke, and they drink, and then they do so many other sinful things, you know, so that, you know, you wouldn't want to think of them as Krishna. But at the same time, we understand their souls, they're part of Krishna. So you have to be cautious about thinking everybody's Krishna. I would be very careful, very cautious about that kind of thinking, that everyone's Krishna. That's Mayavadi philosophy.
So, my question is that how can I introduce this holy sutra with a few word sentence so that they will be interested to understand this book.
Well, you should tell them this is the science of self-realization, to understand who we are. And to understand how to control the mind and the senses. And to know about the next life, what determines our next life. So they should read the book carefully. And if they have any questions, then they should come and ask you.
如果他们阅读过程当中遇到问题, 可以来询问您。
Or you can read the book with them and discuss with them.
或者呢, 您跟他们一起来阅读这本书籍, 并且与此同时进行讨论。
Alright.
Okay. 下一个问题是来自于李莹, new people, 14组李莹, 顶拜guru, 感谢主持人, 今天听到guru讲了一些 Krishna的逍遥时光很甜美, 孩子们一般喜欢听各种故事, 我们有什么书, 有比较多的 Krishna的逍遥时光, 顶拜guru的话说, So this devotee, she want to know, she heard some very sweet lila of Krishna from today's lecture, and she said that because children like to hear story, she would want to know, are there any books that have many Krishna's pastime story?
Yes, you can read the Krishna book. There's a book called the Krishna book. And called Krishna, the reservoir of pleasure.
Yes.
That book.
是的, 您可以给他们读 Krishna, 快乐的泉源这部书。
All the pastimes of Krishna, the life of Krishna is all described in all different pastimes.
所有 Krishna的逍遥时光, Krishna的生活, 就是描述了这本书中有所描述。
Very nice pastimes, very good for children to hear.
里面都很精彩的逍遥时光, 孩子们都很爱听。
下一个问题。
下一个, Shyamasaki, Hare Krishna, 你们 Gurudev 和所有奉献者, 奉献者以全人的爱, 服务 Krishna, 温达文的, 那么温达文的花草树木动物他们没有人体躯体来服务 Krishna 得到超然的品味 这种以Krishna中性关系服务 能得到跟 Krishna之间纯粹的爱心交流吗 是不是跟我们现在怀着服务的心态有关呢? So she, the Hare Krishna business group and all devotees, and devotees love and serve Krishna with wholeheartedly. But what about those flowers, grass, trees, and animals of Vrindavan? They don't have a human body to serve Krishna and to get transcendental mellow. So, to serve Krishna with such a neutral relationship, can they have an affectionate relationship, affectionate dealing with Krishna? Can they get pure, loving communication with Krishna?
Yes. Yes, they can. In the spiritual world, all the living entities have consciousness. All these flowers and trees and plants and animals, they're all there in the spiritual world. And they take these bodies for the pleasure of Krishna.
所有这些花草树木动物他们都是有知觉着的而且他们有着这样的躯体形式呢都是为了让 Krishna 高兴
they will take this you see in the spiritual world we explain the living entities they have this yoga powers and they can change forms and they can take different forms just simply for the pleasure of Krishna. So sometimes they will come as a flower, sometimes they'll come as a tree, sometimes they'll come as an animal.
在灵性世界呢，他们都有着那个瑜伽，他们可以改变他们的身体，他们可以变成任何一种样子。 仅仅是为了让Krishna高兴，或者是他们有的时候呢，以花的形式出现，有时候以树木的形式出现，有时候以动物的形式出现。
Yeah, they just, they're only thinking because we're talking about in the spiritual world. So in the spiritual world, they're all pure souls, so they take these bodies. But in the material world. The living entities who have in trees and flowers and so on, they're not pure, but they have consciousness. But their consciousness is polluted.
我们说的是灵性的，在灵性世界那些纯粹的灵魂，在物质世界的生物呢，他们是不纯粹的，他们有着知觉，但是他们被知觉被污染了。 So the next part is that according to the mood that we are serving now?
Yes, you could say that. Our desire, because, according to our relationship, you see, living entities, we all have a particular rasa with Krishna. So according to whatever rasa we have with Krishna, we will want to serve Krishna in that way.
每个生物呢都跟 Krishna 之间有着特定的 rasa， 所以它会以特定的方式来服务 Krishna。
Just now we're cultivating the mood of being the servant of Krishna, and as we go on serving Krishna. Krishna will reveal more what is our actual spiritual position.
现在呢，我们都是以仆人的身份在服务 Krishna. 随着我们的服务的进展， Krishna 会向我们揭示我们的灵性地位。
But here, we are the servants, eternally the servants. In every rasa, one is the servant.
但是现在呢，我们是仆人，而且我们永恒的是仆人。嗯。Yeah.
So gopis are also servants. The cowherd boys are also servants. Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda, parents, they're also servants.
牛姑娘，他们是仆人，他们牧牛童，他们也是仆人，还有南达大君的亚瑟的妈妈，他们也都是父母，他们是 Krishna 父母，他们也是仆人，就在每一个 rasa 当中都有仆人的这种心态。
And some people are in this shantaras, this neutral position. So they appreciate the beauty of Krishna, but they don't do service.
性的关系当中呢，他们是欣赏 Krishna 的美丽，但是他们没有做，没有去做出积极的服务。
Yeah. Okay.
下一个淡然一笑。如果我是50多岁的老头，找一个年轻奉献者当妻子，他可以帮助我灵性进步，那不行吗？
Translate.
So, if I'm in my 50s, yeah, old people, and I find a new young devotee as my wife, and she can help me to achieve spiritual progress, isn't that okay?
Well, we have to see it. Do you know how much you're going to make spiritual progress and how much you're going to become attached to the young woman?
那我们要看，您到底得到了多少灵性进步，还是变得对这个年轻的姑娘取得了很多的依附呢？
You'd be better to, usually the Vedic system is that you associate, men associate with men. And you make spiritual advancement in the association of other men. Women also, they get spiritual advancement, they associate with other women. But you associate with a young woman, like as your wife, then it's very dangerous.
按照伟达的制度呢，是男人和男人联谊可以取得进步，很多进步。女性和女性联谊可以取得，可以再取得进步。但如果您，跟一个年轻姑娘联谊，那会有很多的危险。
You can try.
您可以试试。
But you know, it's not recommended.
但是这个是不受到推荐的这种做法。
Vedic system says after 50, you're supposed to go to the forest. You're supposed to retire. Because half the life is over. You have to prepare for the next life.
Veda 制度是人过了50岁以后呢，就应该进入森林去退隐了。因为人的半生已经过去了，应当为来生要做准备了。
But marrying a young woman is not the best way to prepare for spiritual advancement.
但是娶一个年轻姑娘，对于取得灵性进步不是一个更好的方法。
If you're very sense controlled, then you don't really need to get married.
如果您确实真正的控制了感官，那不需要结婚。
But you may feel it's important, and you know, like in China, it's important. You should have a wife. You know, family life is very important. People generally have a family. You have a wife, and if you don't, then you're different. You're really different from everybody. People think you're strange. So if you think like that, then you know maybe that, you know, you want to have a wife, then you can do it. But you have to be careful. You have to be careful that you don't get bewildered by the association of the young woman.
但如果就是在中国呢，如果呢您觉得总是保持单身不结婚，那么就与众不同。 如果您有一直有这种想法的话，那么可以，但是呢，要小心，不要被年轻姑娘迷惑了，困惑了。
Okay, so finish.
好，下还有，又来了一个，还有一个问题是有一个线下提的，我们先来回答，就是再还有一个 Fairy 顶麦咕噜，感恩咕噜的精彩解答。我们一家老小喜欢晚睡晚起，我跟他们一起住。要早睡早起困难，我该一个人单独住吗？但这样家人又不开心。So she said that the family members like to sleep late, get up late, and it's difficult for me to live with them. Should I live separately with them? But in this way, the family members will not be very happy.
Yes, I know.Well, these are the problems of family life.
这是家庭生活的困难。
Especially when the family are not devotees.
特别是如果家庭成员并不是奉献者。
So they sleep late, they get up late, they have a different lifestyle from devotees.
他们晚睡晚起跟奉献者是不同的生活方式。
I don't know what is your relationship with the family. Is it your mother and father, or what, your husband, or what?
我不知道您指的家人呢，是指的跟父母，是父母还是丈夫？
Hare Krishna, Gurudev. 对 ，Ferry 是刚才提问，就是40多岁还单身的那一位，他自己。他现在单身，然后应该是跟父母家人住在一起。
Okay. So, your parents are old. They probably need you to take care of them.
那您的父母可能已经年迈了，就需要您照顾，需要人照顾。
So difficult for you to leave them. You certainly they wouldn't like it. A single woman going away, living on your own.They'll worry about you.
然后呢，就是您又是一个人单身的女性，所以呢，他们可能会为您担心。
Difficult. If you've been living with them all your life, and you then.They would certainly not like that you go away and leave them at this point in their life.
So, 就挺难的，因为您一辈子呢一直都跟父母生活在一起，所以肯定呢，就是已经到了现在这个阶段，就很难离开他们了。
These are just some of the problems. Some things are very difficult to overcome. Some of these obstacles. You have to try to make some arrangement. Maybe you could get up and you can go out early in the morning, go for a walk, come back when they get up.
所以这个是属于生活当中遇到的难题，要努力的去克服他们。您可以安排吧，就是早上早点起来，然后就出去到外面散步，然后等他们起床的时候呢，这时候您就回到家中。
And you could talk to them, tell them you want to wake up earlier in the morning. That ask them how what you can do. If they agree to you moving out, then you can move out. But may not be so easy.
Okay. Now there's a question. Yesterday, a devotee, Lila Myra Dika Manaji, asked a question about the Bhagavad Gita.
Yeah.
In chapter 13, text 13, 14, so up until text 13, says about us talk about the individual soul, chetra gyan, and the soul, and then from text 14 talk about the super soul, and the super soul's hand and legs and eyes and hands and face everywhere, and in this way super soul exists. So her question is that, 我先说一下中文。 昨天有一个Lila Myra Dika问了个问题，是有关于《佛教梵歌》第十三章、十三世界谈到个体灵魂、超灵的关系。他很好奇，当离开躯体之后，个体灵魂到底感知到了什么？纯粹的个体灵魂没有物质覆盖的灵魂，是以什么方式感知这个物质世界的 ？So she is curious that after leaving the body, whatever indeed the individual soul will perceive, and the pure individual soul without any material covering, in which way they perceive this material world. Thank you, Hare Krishna.
In which way do they perceive the material world?
Yes.
Well, the pure soul will see the material world in relation to Krishna. Just like they asked Prabhupada about this, and Prabhupada said, just like when a mother sees her child's shoes, then she recognizes, this is my child's shoes, and she thinks of her child. So the same way the devotee sees a tree, he will see the tree, they will think Krishna's tree. They see everything in relation to Krishna. They understand Krishna is the proprietor.
They will put Krishna with
So it's not that you have to see hands and legs everywhere and heads and you see the universal form, but you simply understand everything in relation to Krishna.
所以这里说到那个超灵的手脸、足眼，他们无处不在。所以你不一定非得看到的是宇宙形体，而是把一切都看到的是和 Krishna 有关系，看到一切都跟 Krishna 有关系。So
the universal forms a temporary material manifestation.
所以宇宙形体是短暂的展示。
That 13th chapter, that section you're reading is describing, yeah, the universal, the super soul, But it doesn't mean that the pure devotee has to see all these things every time.
所以第十三章就描述到了超灵他的眼睛手足无处不在，但是纯粹的奉献者并不意味着每一次纯粹奉献者都是这样看的。
No. Krishna says in the sixth chapter, he says, for one who sees me everywhere and sees everything in me, I am never lost to him, nor is he ever lost to me.
Krishna 在第六章说，对谁要是在万事万物当中看到我，也在我当中看到一切的话，他永远不会失去我，我也永远不会失去他。
So sometimes Krishna may reveal the super soul. Sometimes, you know, the yogi meditating on the super soul, they may realize the super soul, but they don't see it all the time.
有的时候 Krishna 会揭示他的超灵的这个特征，但是瑜伽师他们觉悟到超灵不是一直都在那里觉悟到的超灵。
Yeah.
So she is curious also about the spiritual senses. So she asked, in the transcendental state, how the spiritual senses of the individual souls manifest?
No, the spiritual senses are there, but we have spiritual senses, but they're covered.We're spiritual beings, right? We're all spirit souls, and we have a spiritual body, and that spiritual body has spiritual senses. So it's already there.
灵性的感官一直都在那里，就是我们是被覆盖了，灵魂它有一个灵魂是有着灵性的躯体的，那灵性躯体它是意味着有感官的。
So when you go to the spiritual world, the spiritual body is manifest with spiritual senses.
如果您去了灵性世界，那灵性的身体就会展示出来了。
And here in this world, our senses can become spiritualized when we connect them to Krishna, to Krishna's service.
在这里，在物质世界，感官可以被灵性化。当我们把感官和 Krishna 联系在一起，跟 Krishna 的服务联系在一起。
All right.
Mara, there is
Hare Krishna. Good day.
Yeah.
您时间还允许吗？我们后面有两个问题，要不等到周六晚上再回答，已经超时了。
嗯哼，
看您时间。
Okay, Guru Mani, 你要说什么？
我要说就是还有一个问题出来了，
就是我们后面有两个问题还没有回答的。
嗯，
我们是留到下次还是今天？
嗯。你可以留到下次星期六，我们有时间多。
好的，好，那我们今天就到这里吧，因为已经超了十多分钟了。
嗯 ，OK， Hare Krishna， 感谢 Guru Mani Mataji， 感谢 Santa Mataji， 感谢你们，感谢所有的奉献者聆听，祝福你们生日快乐，节日快乐。Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.